past an aged man with hoary hairs, wrinkled and curved with worldly cares. "Time is the warp of life," he said. "Oh, tell the young, the fair, the gay, to weave it well." I asked the ancient, venerable dead, sages who wrote and warriors who bled, from the cold grave of a hollow murmur flowed, "Time sowed the seed we reap in this abode." I asked a dying sinner ere the tide of life had left his veins, "Time," he replied, "I've lost it, all the treasure," and he died. I asked the golden sun and silver spheres, those bright chronometers of days and years, they answered, "Time is but a meteor glare," and bade me for eternity prepare. I asked the seasons in their annual round, which beautify or desolate the ground, and they replied, no oracle more wise, "'Tis folly's blank and wisdom's highest prize." I asked a spirit lost, but oh, the shriek that pierced my soul, I shudder while I speak, it cried, "A particle, a speck, a mite, of endless years, duration infinite." Of things inanimate, my dial I consulted, and it made me this reply, "Time is the season, fair of living well, the path of glory or the path of hell." I asked my Bible, and methinks it said, "Time is the present hour, the past has fled. Live, live today, tomorrow never yet on any human being rose or set." I asked old Father Time himself at last, but in a moment he flew swiftly past. His chariot was a cloud of viewless wind, his noiseless steeds which left no trace behind. I asked the mighty angel who shall stand 1 foot on sea and 1 on solid land. "Mortal," he cried, "the mystery now is over. Time was, time is, but time shall be no more.